여러분 반갑습니다. 오늘이 31번째 연강이 되겠습니다. 오늘은 A Case Study of Simple Linear Regression in R Programming Language. 자, 여러분 오늘은 이 케이스 스터디를 하나 여러분들과 같이 공부하도록 그렇게 하겠습니다. 자, A Case Study of Simple Linear Regression in R. 자, Problem with Cars Dataset. 여러분들 이 R 스튜디오가 제공하는 이 Cars라는 그 데이터셋이 있습니다. 이 자동차의 이 스피드와 거리의 그 데이터. 자, for this analysis, we will use the cars dataset that comes with R by default. Cars is a standard built-in dataset that makes it convenient to demonstrate linear regression in a simple and easy to understand fashion. You can access this data set simply by trying in cars in your R console. You will find that it consists of 50 observations and two variables, including distance and speed. Let's print out the first six observations by using the command head cars to display the first six observations of the car data set. Speed, number of observation from 1 to 6, speed and distance. Before we begin building the regression model, it's a good practice to analyze and understand the variables. The graphical analysis and correlation study below will help with this. Graphical analysis. The aim of this exercise is to build a simple regression model that we can use to predict distance by establishing a statistical significant linear relationship with speed. But before jumping in to the syntax, let's try to understand these variables graphically. Typically, for each of the independent variables called predictors, the following plot are drawn to visualize the following behavior. Scatter plot to visualize the linear relationship between predictor independent variable and response dependent variable. Box plot is to spot any outlier observations in variable. Having outliers in your predictor can drastically affect the predictions, as they can easily affect the direction, slope of the lines of best fit. Density plot is to see the distribution of predictor variable, ideally a close to normal distribution, a bell-shaped curve without being skewed to the left or right is preferred. Let us see how to make each one of them. Scatter plot can help visualize any linear relationship between dependent variable and independent variables. Ideally, if you are having multiple predictor variables or scatter plot is drawn for each one of them against the response dependent variable along with the line of best as seen below. The command of R scatter.smooth x equal car dollar sign speed speed column y equal car dollar sign distance column name main distance tilde speed here distance speed scatter plot and with the line this scatter plot along with the smoothing line above suggested linearly increasing relationship between distance and speed. This is a good thing because one of underlying assumption in linear regression is that the relationship between response dependent variable and predictor variable or independent variable is linear and additive. So we can use box plot to separate our layer in the car data set. Generally, any data point is lies outside the 1.5 inner quartile range is considered on our layer where IQR inner quartile range is calculated by the distance between 25th percentile and 75th percentile values for that variable. These are the commands for box plot to separate outlier. In speed, there is no outlier, but in dependent variable, response variable, distance, we can find out on outlier here. This outlier is out of 25th percentile and 75th percentile values. Just one outlier here. Okay. Outlier rows 120. Density plot can be used to check if response variable is close to normality. Plot density. Density plot speed here, density plot distance here, blue is for speed, red color is for distance. So these two density plot look like normal, approximately normally distributed. Correlation is a statistical measure that suggests the level of linear dependency between two variables that occur in pair, just like what we have here in speed and distance. Correlation can take values between minus 1 to plus 1. If we observe for every distance instance where speed increase, the distance also increase along with it, then there is a high positive correlation between speed and distance. And therefore, the correlation between them will be closer to plus 1. The opposite is true for an inverse relationship, in which case the correlation between the variables will be close to minus 1. A value closer to 0 suggests a weak relationship between the variables. A low correlation probably suggests that much of variation of response variable is unexplained by the predictor independent variable, in which case we should probably look for better explanatory variables. In this case, correlation between speed and distance is 0.806a. So high correlationship between speed independent variable and distance dependent variables. Let's build a linear regression model. Now that we have seen the linear relationship pictorially in the scatter plot and by computing the correlation, let's see the syntax for building the linear model. The function used for building linear model is lm method or command. Lm stands for linear model. The lm function takes in two main arguments, namely formula and data. The data is typically a data frame. The formula is an object of class formula, but the most common convention is to write out the formula directly in place of the argument as written below, like these instructions regarding R programming linear regression model equal LM distance. Distance means dependent variable and independent variable speed. Data is car data set. Print linear regression model and then coefficient intercept minus 17.579 speed coefficient beta 2, beta 1, beta 2, beta 2 coefficient is 3.932. Now that we have built linear model, we also have established the relationship between the predictor independent variable and response dependent variable in the form of a mathematical formula for distance as a function for speed. For the above output, you can notify the coefficient part having two components, intercept and speed. These are also called the beta coefficient. In other words, distance equal minus 17.579 plus 3.932 speed. So distance is functionally depend upon the independent variable speed. Linear regression diagnostics. Now the linear model is built and we have a formula that we have used to predict the distance value if a corresponding speed is known. Is this enough to actually use the model? No. Before using regression model, you have to ensure that is statistically significant. How do you ensure this? Let's begin by printing the summary statistics for the linear regression model. Summary, linear regression model, and then residual coefficient, intercept, and speed, and standard error, t value, and p value. Star mark, three star mark means 100% confidence interval. Two means 99%, 90%, 95%. So the null hypothesis can be rejected. So beta 2 is then equal to 0. Beta 2 3.9324. So distance can be vary by independent variable speed. The p-value for checking for statistical significance. The summary statistic above tells us a number of things. One of them is the model p-value. The p-value of individual predictor variables, extremely right column on the coefficient. The p-values are very important because we can consider linear model to be statistically significant only when both these p-values are less than the predetermined statistical significance level, which is ideally 5% or alpha equal 0.05. This is visually interpreted by significant stars at the end of the row. The more the stars beside the variable's p-value, the more significant the variable. Null and alternative hypothesis, as I mentioned earlier, when there is a p-value, there is a null and alternative hypothesis associated with it. In linear regression, null hypothesis is that the coefficient associated variable is equal to zero. On the other hand, the alternate hypothesis is that coefficient is not equal to zero. Thus, there exists a relationship between dependent variables in question and the dependent variable. T value, we can interpret the T value something like this. A larger T value indicate that it's less likely that coefficient is not equal to zero purely by chance. So higher T value is the better. P value is the probability that you get a t value as a high or higher than the observed value when the null hypothesis beta is equal to zero or that there is no relationship is true. So if the p value is low, the coefficient are significant. This means significant is different from zero. If the p-value is high, the coefficient are not significant. What this means to us, when p-value is less than significance level 0.05, we can safely reject the null hypothesis that the coefficient beta of predictor is zero. In our case, linear regression model, both these p-values are well below the 0.05 threshold. So we can conclude that our model is indeed statistically significant. It's absolutely important for the model to be statistically significant before we can go ahead and use it to predict or estimate the dependent variable, otherwise the confidence in predicted values from the model reduces and maybe construed as an event of chance. How to calculate t statistics and p value when model coefficient and standard error are known? The formula for calculating t statistic and p value as follows: t statistic is equal to beta minus coefficient of standard error. How to calculate the t statistic and p value? Model summary. Model summary, and then we can see this information regarding linear regression model. So star mark indicate that the level of significance for the testing the hypothesis. Okay, R square and unadjusted R square. The actual information in a data is total variation it contains. Remember, what R square did tell us the proportion of variation dependent variable, response variable that has been explained by this model. R square is equal to 1 minus SS, sum of square, sum of squared error over SST, sum of squared the total, where SAC sum of square error and SACE sum of square total SST. We don't necessarily discard a model based on a row R squared value. It's better practice to look at AIC, archived information criterion, and prediction accuracy on validation sample when deciding on efficacy of a model. Now, that's about R squared. What about unadjusted R squared? As you add more X variables to your model, the R squared value of a new bigger model will always be greater than that of the smaller subset. This is because since all the variables in original model is also present, their contribution to explain the dependent variable will be present in the superset as well. Therefore, whatever new variable we add can only add, if not significantly, to the variation that was already explained. It's here the unadjusted R square value comes to help. Unadjusted R square penalizes total value for the number of terms in your model. Therefore, when comparing nested models, it's a good practice to look at adjusted R square value over R squared. R square adjusted value is equal to 1 minus MSE mean squared error over mean squared total n is the number of observation, q is the number of coefficients in the model. Therefore, by moving around numerators and denominators, the relationship between r square and r adjusted square becomes r adjusted square is equal to 1 minus r square multiplied by n minus 1 over n minus q. 보스 스탠다드 에러스 앤 에프 스태티스틱 아 메이저 오브 굿니스 오브 핏 스탠다드 에러 이즈 이퀄 투 루트 민 스퀘어드 에러 이즈 이퀄 투 루트 민 스퀘어드 에러 오버 n 마이너스 큐 에프 스태티스틱 이즈 이퀄 투 msr 오버 mse MSR mean square regression calculated as like this formula. AIC and BIC archive case information criterion. This technique is developed by Arkaid, Professor Arkaid in 1974 Bayesian information criterion BIC developed by originated by Schwartz in 1978 AIC and BIC are measures of the goodness of fit of unestimated statistical model can also be used for model selection. Both criteria depend on the maximized value of likelihood function for estimated model. The AIC is defined as AIC is equal to minus 2 multiplied by ln L plus 2 multiplied by K where K is the number of model parameters. BIC can be computed using this formula. N is the sample size. For model comparison, the model with the lowest AIC and BIC score is preferred. AIC linear regression model is 419.1569 BIC is 424.8929 자 여러분 이 AIC, BIC 그 다음에 뭐 이거 말고도 뭐 여러 가지 있습니다. 이것을 우리가 이 마대를 선택할 때, 자, y는 equal ax plus alpha, 아니, beta 1, beta 0 plus beta 1 x1, beta 2 x2, beta 3 x3, 뭐 이렇게, 이 independent variable이 많을 때, 어떤 variable 넣고 빼고 해가지고, 여러분들 그 regression 마대를 계속 리파인 할 수 있잖아 그죠? 그때 우리가 이 AIC, BIC를 이렇게 계산을 RStudio 가지고 계산하면 그 AIC, BIC value가 lowest 가장 낮은 마델이 X 독립 변수가 종속 변수를 가장 잘 R2가 adjusted R2가 가장 높다는 거야. 그러니까 우리가 이 AIC, BIC, LASSO, RICH 이런 기준을 가지고 우리가 이 model fitting이라고 그래, statistic regression model fitting을 하는 방법이야. AIC, BIC, LASSO, RICH C 뭐 이런 거 여러분들 많습니다. 기준이 우리가 뭐이 AIC, BIC 정도만 알아도 매우 성공적인 거야 지금. How to know if the model is best fit for your data? The most common metric to look at while selecting the model are R-squared, adjusted R-square, F-statistic, so on. 자, 여기 R-square, higher the better. 자, minimum, 우리가 regression 모델이 R-square가 0.7 이상은 돼야 우리가 acceptable하다 그런 얘기입니다. Adjusted R-squared 마찬가지. Higher the better. F-statistics. 이거 higher the better. Standard error close to zero the better. T-statistics should be greater than 1.96 for p-value to be less than 95%. Confidence interval AIC lower the better, BIC lower the better, Morlos CP should be close to number of predictors in model, MAPE mean absolute percentage error lower the better, mean squared error lower the better, mean max accuracy is higher the better. 자, 여러분, 우리가 이 모델이 어떤 게 좋은지, 모델 피팅을 할 때, 이런 스태티스틱을 가지고 우리가 이런 크라이테리온으로 판단을 합니다. 매우 중요한 거지, 그지요? 자, predicting linear models. So far we have seen how to build linear regression model using the whole data set. If we build it that way, there is no way to tell how the model will perform with the new data. So the preferred practice is to split your data set into 80-20 sample. One is training set, the other is testing set, data set. Then build the model on the 80% sample and then use the model thus built to predict the dependent variables on the test data. Doing it this way, we will have the model predicted value for 20% data for test as well as the actual from the original data set by calculating accuracy measures like min max accuracy and error rate, MAPE and MSE. We can find out the prediction accuracy of the model. Now let's see how to actually do this. First step, create training and test data samples from original data by using these R program commands. Set seed training row index sample and row cost 80% row indexes for training data for model training data and test data. Second step is to develop the model on training data. Use it to predict distance on test data like this. So the step is to review diagnostic measures. Level of significance. R-squared, adjusted R-square, F-statistics, p-value, AIC. Predicting linear models. Fourth step is to calculate prediction accuracy and error rate. Simple correlation between actual and predicted values can be used as a form of accuracy measure. A higher correlation accuracy implies that the actual and predicted values have a similar directional movement. That's when the actual values increase, the predicted also increase, and vice versa. Actual predicted values make actual predicted data frame correlation accuracy. Correlation is correlation between distance and speed is 82.7%. So had six observation, display six observations, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 from top. Now let's calculate the mean max accuracy and MAPE. Mean max accuracy is equal to mean mean over max, mean absolute percentage error, MAPE, mean absolute over actual. So mean max accuracy is 0.73, MAPE is 0.495 by using RStudio. Okay, 오늘 강의는 여기까지 하겠습니다. 다음 32회 연강에서는 Extension of Two Variable Linear Regression Model에 대해서 공부하도록 그렇게 하겠습니다. 여러분 40분간 집중하시느냐고 수고하셨습니다.